Welcome to Mariner of the Seas. Mariner of the Seas is a second-generation Voyager-class cruise ship of Royal Caribbean International. As of this cruise, the ship's home port was Port Canaveral, Florida. However, in early 2024, it is being moved to sail out of Galveston, Texas. You board Mariner of the Seas on Deck 4, so we'll start the tour there. Deck 4 Forward is the upper level of the Royal Theater. The Royal Theater is on decks 3 and 4 Forward and hosts original musical style shows and game shows. Download the Royal Caribbean app and be sure to make reservations early as the shows do fill up quick. If you forgot to make a reservation, they do have standby. As you exit Royal Theater on Deck 4, you will arrive at the Schooner Bar, a warm-lit nautical-themed lounge. The Schooner Bar has live music and perfectly mixed cocktails for purchase or with your beverage package. It also hosts some of the games on the ship. The Izumi Hibachi and Sushi restaurant is across from the Schooner Bar. Izumi is open for lunch and dinner and offers an exotic Asian-inspired dining experience. There is an additional charge to eat here and it is not part of your cruise package. Next is the casino. The casino covers around 9,600 square feet with more than 30 table games and around 300 slot machines. It has a cocktail bar and a staircase to the promenade. You must be 18 years of age or older to play in the casino, and the casino is closed to gambling while in port. After exiting the casino, you will arrive at a centrum overlooking the art gallery. On one side is Boleros, a Latin-inspired lounge offering Latin rhythms and drinks, and on the other side is Starbucks. Boleros and Starbucks both have beverages for an additional purchase. Boleros is included with your drink package if you have one. Starbucks is not. At the aft of the ship is the main dining room. It has three levels on decks 3, 4, and 5. The main dining room is included in your cruise fare and offers a different menu each evening with a few dishes that are available every night. It is a formal dining experience with exceptional multi-course menu options. Plan to dine for at least an hour. There are three dining time options, 5:30, 8:30, or anytime dining. When you have a specific dining time, you sit at the same table with the same staff each evening, so your table is immediately available for you. Anytime dining is like standby, and you'll be seated as seats become available. Going down to Deck 3 from the dining room takes you to the Art and Photo Gallery. Beyond that is Studio B, Mariner of the Seas ice skating rink. It is a multi-purpose studio filled with activity throughout the day, from ice skating to ballroom dance lessons. Check your Royal Caribbean app for the daily schedule and make reservations as needed. On Deck 3, you cannot get from one end of the ship to the other. You will need to go up a floor, cross, and go back down a floor to get to the Royal Theater or rooms at Ships Forward. Unless you have a room on deck 2 or are participating in a meeting in their conference center, there's no need to go there. So let's head up to deck 5, the promenade deck. Here you will find the shore excursion desk, guest services and next cruise, and then the promenade. The promenade is where you will find many shops. You'll also find restaurants and bars. Sports bars. Cafe and ice cream parlor. And a unique feature of the Royal Caribbean is you can rent a room facing the promenade. And at night, the promenade turns into a party. Beyond that is the library, and the Star Lounge, which is the ship's second show lounge with a range of activities from live music, dancing, art auctions, and open gameplay. There is a small outer deck at the very forward of the ship with a helicopter pad. There are only rooms on deck 6 through 10, so we will show you our balcony room and then we'll resume the tour on deck 11. At the aft of the ship on deck 11 is the Windjammer. You will probably find yourself here often as the Windjammer is the ship's buffet-style dining. You will see Chops Grill and Jamie's Italian Restaurant in the Windjammer. Both of these restaurants have an additional cost if you dine there. Beyond that is the adult-only solarium. There you'll find a pool, a pair of whirlpools, a bar, plus loungers and large day beds to relax on. You must be 18 years of age or older to enjoy the solarium. At Deck 11 Forward is the Vitality at the Sea Fitness Center. The fitness center is fully equipped with free weights, stationary machines, spin bikes, stair steppers, treadmills, sauna, steam room, and thermal suites. Access to the fitness center is complimentary to all guests. However, some of the classes do have an additional charge. From inside the fitness center, you can take the stairs up to the spa, or there's a main entrance to the spa on Deck 12. Deck 12 Forward is the Vitality at Sea Spa and the Spa Suites. The possibilities for pampering are endless, from lavish salon treatments like manicures, pedicures, and hair services, to spa treatments like facials, massages, and body wraps. Check your Royal Caribbean app for prices. And on sail away day, they offer a tour of the spa and participants have a chance to win a raffle for free spa services. At midship is the Skybox. It is an open air lounging area with a bar and a running track. You can also look down at Deck 11's pool area from there. And then at the aft of the ship is the nursery, all of the children's clubs, Johnny Rockets, and a video arcade. Mariner Dunes, the putt-putt golf course, is on Deck 13 Forward. Deck 13 is another deck that you cannot go from one end to the other. You will need to go down to 12, cross, and go back up to get to the other side of Deck 13. And on the other side of Deck 13, you're going to find a ton of outdoor activities. The water slides, the sports court, the rock climbing wall, the sky climber, and flow rider are all at the aft of the ship on Deck 13. As is the SkyPad, which will be eliminated on all ships in early 2024. Deck 14 is only at Ships Forward. Here, you'll find the Viking Crown Lounge and a jazz club available to all guests. However, you will also find the Suite Lounge and Diamond Club Lounge, which can only be accessed if you are either a suite holder or you are part of the Diamond Club. And from this area, you will find a stairway to the escape room, which is an additional fee with reservations required. Thank you for joining us on this tour of the Mariner of the Seas. Hope you enjoy your next cruise.